Good morning, afternoon, evening. This is Taz. Welcome back to Taz's Wig Closet. Today I have a brand new style by Raquel Welch to show you for the spring 2023 collection. This is one that I had to have. You know me, I love curl. Raquel Welch's curly style called Click Click Flash in my favorite shaded biscuit. We're gonna unbox it, wig it up, and style it coming up. I purchased this wig from Wig Studio One. You can find it there. All you need to do is go below this video, expand the description box under the video. I will attach a direct product link. It'll be labeled Raquel Welch Click Click Flash. If you click on that, it will take you out to the site. You can see all of the color options and the pricing. If you have any questions for us, please reach out to support@wigstudio1.com. And don't forget to visit us on our private Facebook group called the Wig Studio One Wig and Topper Support Group. So I cannot wait. Let's just get started. This is that curly, curly style. I have a feeling it's going to be a very dense, curly style. The curl should be all over. See that in the box. We know we are in for some curly days with this one. Does anybody remember the Glam Slam by Raquel Welch that was out years ago? That one reminded me a lot of like a Jamila Plus by Ellen Villa. A large barrel type curl. It was called Glam Slam. They discontinued that style, at least here in the United States. I don't know if it's still available anywhere else. But oh my gosh, look at this. Look at all of those tightly compacted ringlets in there. Oh my gosh, it looks like one of those old judge wigs that they used to wear. Look at that. Oh my gosh. That is so tightly compacted that there is no way that you can wear this right out of the box. You're going to have to do stuff to this. But I imagine we can make it look really beautiful. Let's take a look at this cap. Now, this is one of the lace front open cap wigs by Raquel Welch. I think I had it recently on the It Curl. And this one actually, the lace front looks a little bit deeper than that one. So that lace front looks like it's every bit an inch to an inch and a half back from the edge of the lace here. And that stripe that you see is the highlight that they brought up to the lace front. And we're gonna take a look at that when it's applied. But then you have open top, sides, and back, a closed velvet ear tab, really nice, strong, sturdy stays, an extended felted nape with the Velcro style adjusters. This is a part of the memory cap series. So you're gonna see elastics along those weft bindings there. That gives a nice custom like fit. Now we are going to discuss this fit right out of the box so that I can assess that for you and you'll know how it fits. A lot of times Raquel Welch styles fit me very large and I have to make an exaggerated adjustment to accommodate my petite average circumference. That is not true on all of the Raquel Welch styles, however. So we are going to talk about it. All right, are you ready? This is gonna be that moment where you apply a wig like this and you look in the mirror and you freak out just a little bit. But as I said, you cannot take curls at their face value because they do need work. Now you notice this one also has a lot of silicone on it. So if you're picking up that it looks a little greasy, it's not, it's just the silicone from the factory. But my goodness, that curl goes up to the root, within an inch of that rooting space there. You can see that curl. So this is not a shy curly style. This is full on, look at me and my curl curl. Did I tell you or did I tell you? But it is adorable. Even like it is now, this isn't probably a look that I would take out of the house right now before doing something, but I can always see upon a first application, I can always see the potential. The first thing that I need to let you know here though is this cap fits me well with a petite average circumference. I don't think I'm gonna have to make much of an adjustment at all. There's no baggy cap. It fits secure around the circumference. So again, I feel like this one, like the other one in this collection that I've explored, the Captivating Canvas, they fit a little more average compared to the normal Raquel Welch. So just be aware of that. Now, I am going to remove it though, because I do want to work on waking up this fiber. That's going to be a big part of making this style my own. And that's where we start. We start by waking up the fiber. Now, I will tell you that you don't want to do this, however, unless you're sure you're going to keep it. So this is one of those styles that it's almost impossible to know if you're going to keep it or not until you start working with it. But if you start working with it, you may jeopardize your return. So just be aware that sometimes that can happen. That's sort of just a reality. So I'm going to shake it out. I'm going to rake it out. So I have a wide tooth comb. And that's the only thing that I want to use on this. But if you try to brush out this curl or use a fine tooth comb, you're gonna end up with a frizzy mess. We don't want that either. So I'm just gonna gently comb at the root. It's already starting to sort of bush out a little bit. So I'm just gently pulling in just little short strokes at the root. I'm not carrying through all the way to the tip of the fiber. Okay, let's try it on again. And then start working with it. I still need to get you the specs and everything. I'm caught up. You can see that, right? Okay, once again, I made no adjustment. Okay, I'm defining a parting space. That's one of the first things that I do. And then I can adjust volume. I've created a monster, haven't I? Okay. No problem, no problem. So let's go over the specs, right around 12 inches in the front, overall about a 12 to 13 inch length. And again, that's gonna depend on how you like wearing these curls. If you like them stretched, it's gonna be a little longer, obviously. One thing that stuck out to me on the specs is this weighs about 6.4 ounces. There's a lot of hair here. This is a thick, thick density. Based on what I can see, it has a lot of permatease. Again, that is very typical of two things. It's an open cap style. You'll typically find more permatease, but it's supposed to have a big voluminous curly look, and that is going to be sustained by the permatease. Okay, so this is a bit of a monster right now, but I can work this just with the heat of my hand. This is one that I'll want to take away from the face a little to style it, just to make it mine and to balance the volume, which you can see here, it's smooth for about the first inch or two, and then it blossoms into this curl. That helps me define a parting space a little easier. So you can see where this one was shocking to me when I pulled it out of the box. Even as a curl lover, it's shocking to me. This is the big retro type curl, isn't it? You can make this absolutely adorable. And the abundance of this curl is going to be a lot of fun for you. Now you can take heat to this because it's heat friendly fiber. So I would not advise straight pressing the style. You're never going to get back the curl if you do that. And there are so many other styles at this length that have feature more of a straight look. You're going to buy this because of the curl, but you can customize the curl. You can stretch it a little bit. What I might do is just use like a hairdryer or something while I'm, you know, kind of point the hot air at it while I'm pulling through, and that will reduce the profile. It'll increase the length. It will stretch these curls a little bit more. So let's just jump right into the styling. I'm gonna move this hair around for you just so you can get a sense of the really thick density, the movement of the hair, inspire you to style your curly wigs and make them your own. We'll see you again soon right here on TAZS's Wig Closet at Wig Studio 1.